Ciao friends! In this video I want to show how to create a chart-friendly data table in Power BI. First of all, why this could be useful? Let's take a look at an example I prepared. In this line chart we have many points, one for each month. But not all the points are visible. I have to use a scroll bar to see all the points in this chart. However, if I enlarge the sides of the visual, I can see all the points. The reason is that the engine is trying to display all the names of all the points. And the reason for that is the axis type for this line chart is a categorical one. When we use the continuous definition, the continuous type, we will see the entire number of points of the visual in the same visual. But this is not possible with this data type. This is not possible with the month name, because the month name is a string. So there is actually a way to solve this problem, and is if I create a column. So let's take a look at the classic date table here. The classic date table is defined in a way where I add a column that is always the last day of the month. And here, if I look at the content here, you see that for March, all the dates in March have the same end of month. And if I use this column in the chart, it just works. Because this is a column of date data type. And if I go back to my chart and I replace here the column that I'm using in this chart, year month, I remove this and I use the end of month that I shown you before. You see that now all the points are visible here and I can reduce the side of the screen, or the side of the visual, and I always see all the points. You can also see that the axis now displays the 2 years, 2008 and 2009, but if I enlarge this, I see a few names of the month, just to have a visual indication of the position of the month. But of course, when I move this around in the tooltip, I see what? I see the data that I defined in my date table. So, can I do something better? Well, actually, yes. I could use the date column displaying the name of the month instead of the date that you see here. But if I do that, I can do more. I can also replace the original month name column with a date that displays the month name in the former string, but actually has as a content a date. So this is what we did in the date table here. So let's go to this definition of the date table. So I'm going to show you, the date table here. Here we go. And this is the definition of the date table. Now, the first thing that you notice is that now I reduced the number of columns that I have in the date table. And if we focus on the year month column here, where I have the definition of the year month, I define this column as an end of month, like the previous column in the previous table. But what is the difference here? If I select this column here, you see that the data type now is date time, but the visualization is still a string. How can I obtain that? Well, instead of displaying the string using the format, the classical format that we have here, we change the custom form a string that we can customize now also for the dates in Power BI using DDD YYYY. Here we go. Now I have only I use DDD, I wanted to use MMM, but this is just a way to show you that if I use the triple D is the name of the day of the week. If I use the triple M, I get the name of the month with three letters. If you wanted the entire full name, you could just use the four letters with the 4M. In the article below, you can see all more details and pointers to how you can define the correct form string. So let's go back to this definition. Now, the advantage of this approach is what? If I go to the visualization, so let me go back to the report, and I go to the visualization that I have with the date table that I've shown you now, not this one, but this one. You see that I already have the visualization that is what I need. So I have the visualization with all the points like we have seen before. But more important, in the tooltip, now you see exactly the name that we used in the custom form string. So we can actually control this. But there is a second advantage. If you think about what I did, I no longer had to add a second column just to display, just to define the sort order of the month names. This column is already sorted. I don't need a sort by column. I don't need a second column. This simplifies my day table and also the DAX code. If you want to create a calculation in DAX where you manipulate or remove the filters from the month, you have to just use the month column instead of the month and the month number. Now, if we go one step further, you can see that at an extreme, I can reduce the number of columns, also using the same approach for the name of the day of the week or the name of the month, using only 12 months. Now, if you think about this, there is a problem. If I want to display the day of the week, if I extracted the day of the week from the current date, I have a string. If I want to display this as a date and I want to use the form string to display the name of the day of the week, I cannot use just the original date, because if I do that, I will see Monday, the same name for different underlying dates. But this will not produce, for example, a chart where I have only 7 days, because I want to group all the dates that are Monday, all the dates that are Tuesday, and so on. So in order to do that, we use a small trick. The day of the week is a date that is in 1900, and we only obtain the corresponding date in the same week of 1900 corresponding to the same day of the week of the current date for each row of your date table. And we can use the same approach for the month name. We only have 12 months for all the years, and by using these two columns, now look at this table. This table has only 5 columns, my date table, and by using this date table with 5 columns, I have first a line chart, regular line chart with all the months in all the years, single line chart, all the months, all the year. Second, a line chart for the month in each year with a different line for each year. And now if you think about this, what I have in the x-axis is the month name, which in reality is a date in 1900, but I only display the month name. And finally, I have here a line chart with 7 days, and I'm aggregating here all the Thursday. Now you could apply other filters, you could create more lines, it just works, but we reduced using this technique, we strongly reduced the number of columns we have in the date table, automatically define the sort order without having to use the sort by column. So this approach, thanks to the custom form string in Power BI that you can apply to the date columns, this approach can simplify your date table and simplify also the way you create the charts in Power BI. Enjoy DAX!